Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. So today we are going to study probability, and the concepts which I am going to use are engineering topic concepts. So let us try and understand what exactly the probability is. So first let us go for the introduction. The basic introduction is: probability of any event depends on the favorable cases and its sample space. So probability of E can be written as the ratio of number of favorable case divided by the total samples. Total samples are nothing but the total possible outcomes. In short, probability of an event can be written as M by N. So if an event is happening, there must be an event which is not happening. So that is a new relation: probability of E plus probability of E bar will always be equal to 1. That means E stands for happening of an event and E bar stands for non-happening of the event. Summing of happening and non-happening of a probability of an event must be equal to 1. That's the first result. Next, few of the textbook use the standard result: probability of event has P and non-happening event has Q. This is a standard representation, so P plus Q is equal to 1. If suppose a question is asked to find the non-happening or happening of the event, as per the requirement, the equations can be rewritten and so forth. The next comes random variable. It's a simple topic. Random variables deals with random experiments, where a real variable X, usually all the random variables are denoted by capital letter. So random experiment, if a real variable X is associated, we are associating this real variable with every outcomes of our experiment. I repeat, a real variable X is associated to every outcome of our experiment. Then the variable which we associated, right, that variable is called random variable, and it is also called stochastic variable. So to understand the definition, let us have a small example. So while tossing of a coin, so obviously tossing of a coin is a random experiment where the outcomes are head or tail. So we can write the sample space S as the set of head and tail. These are the possible outcomes. That is a total outcome for a tossing of a coin. So what we are doing here, we are associating the variable X. We are associating the variable X to each possible outcome. So what are the outcomes we have? Head and tail. So what we have done here, we have assigned a real value for head, which is denoted by 1, and a real value for tail, which is denoted as 0. So how we are going to represent this in terms of random variable? So capital X of head, if we get the outcome whose value will be equal to 1. A random variable X associated to the outcome tail whose value is 0. So this is what the definition, compare with the definition and the problem. It's a random experiment tossing of a coin, and we are assigning a real variable capital X, and it is associated to each outcomes of our trial. So to understand better, we have one more example. Instead of tossing one coin, now we will take an example of tossing of a two coin. So when two coins, obviously we have four possible outcomes: head-head, head-tail, tail-head, tail-tail, right? Assigning the same nature, head is being associated with 1 and tail we are associating it by 0. So let me keep a random variable. That means I need an outcome where the outcome should have number of heads in it. So I am assigning the real variable X whose outcome should be number of heads. Heads we have already denoted by 1, right? So if you get heads, then you can add the value of 1. If you get tail, that's not our outcome. Our outcome is only getting head. So tabulate it. Outcomes, the possible outcomes for a tossing of two coins is head, head, tail, head, tail, tail, and head, tail. So we have a random experiment where our outcome has to be number of heads. So here we have two heads, head is quoted by 1, so 2 heads, so it is denoted by 2, the outcome of the variable. Here we have 1 head, so it is 1, 1 head, one tail. So we have one head here, one. Here we have outcome both the tails, and this is not our favorable outcome. So it is 0. So you can see the value here. It takes 0, 1 and 2. Since it is repeated, you can take it as one time. So the range set of the random variable, this is a range set of the random variable whose values are 0, 1, 2. I hope the definition of random variable with example is clear. Now let us go for the next topic, types of random variables. So here we have two types. One is discrete random variable and continuous random variable. Discrete random variable, as the name indicates, the process will have a break. Continuous random variable is a free flow. So you don't have any break in it, no disturbance in the continuous random variable. So let us understand the definition of discrete. As usual, X indicates a random variable whose outcomes are finite. And you will be having infinite, but it can be countable. That is countably infinite. Then such outcomes we categorize under discrete system. Coming to continuous, you have a random variable X where the outcomes of these random variables are non-countable infinite number. We will not be able to count the outcome. It can tend up to infinity. Okay. So coming to the second point of discrete, example is tossing of a coin, throwing a die, where the process has a break from one experiment to another, one trial to another trial. When it comes to continuous random variable, there won't be any break in the experiment. It is a continuous process. For example, weighing machine, voltmeter, speedometer, which we do it in electrical circuits. Best example is life of a tube light or electric bulbs. How are this going to happen? If you want to examine the life of a bulb, whether it stands for 24 hours or 42 hours or 48 hours, how to check? You plug it, switch it on the bulb and leave it continuously. After few hours, based on the capacity of the bulb will start. Either it will be glowing high or sometimes it stops. So that states that you started at one point and you have ended at another point where there is no break in your experiment. So such type of experiments are nothing but continuous random variable. So coming to the next point, xi is a variable. Okay, it is an event. Whatever event happened, no, that xi value corresponding to the random variable x. Very important condition for both random variables are probability of that whatever the experiment you have conducted, right, it has to be greater than 0. This holds true for continuous also. Probability of event xi should always be greater than 0. Since it is discrete, we will use the term summation. That is, it is adding up all your result called series. Summing up all your results. So we use summation of all the probabilities whatever you have obtained as your outcome, whose value should be equal to 1. Since it is continuous, instead of summation, it is a continuous process. So integrations is applied. Why we are applying integration? Because it's a continuous process. We use summation because it is a discrete process. Just make a note of difference. In discrete, you have summation. In continuous, you have integration. That is only the difference. The rest all is same. Some of the textbook uses f of x as a function. Okay. There is not much difference. Instead of p of x, they have used f of x. Okay. These two are mandatory condition to proceed with the problem. Next comes cumulative distribution function, CDF, or it is also called probability density function. It is nothing but, since it is a function, we denote it as f of x, okay? That is equal to probability of your random variable. As I said, x is nothing but whatever the experiment you have conducted, right? Less than or equal to x. Function, cumulative distribution function is equal to probability of x less than or equal to x. That is equal to summation I ranges to x, where this is our limit. More than that, we cannot extend it. it is not up to infinity here, it is I is equal to 1 to x. You restrict your summation to x, that is the cumulative distribution function. Here we have used summation, right? Same terminology here also exists, but instead of summation, the continuous goes for integration. So integration from minus infinity to x. So these are two important concepts based on that we have n number of problems. So I hope the basic concepts on probability is clear. In the next video, we will have problems based on continuous random variable and discrete random variable. Thanks for watching.